creating tile maps in Phaser, export your tile map as JSON, add it to your Phaser project with the other images in your game map. Preload all images, then your tiled art image, and last the JSON map with the keyword map. Create a map variable with this.add.tilemap, passing the keyword map that references your tiled map data. Add a tiles variable using the tile set name from tiled as the first param, and then the tile set image texture assigned keyword. To create our first layer, the ground layer, use the create layer function on the map, pass in the tile layer name, the tiles variable referencing the tile image, and optional x and y coordinate. Repeat for the obstacle layer. Next, we add object layers using the create from objects function. The first param is the layer name, then an object containing the GID number and the key for the quarter image. To find the GID, go to the JSON map, search the name of the object, and you should find the GID number as a property. Note every reference to the same object has the same GID number. Repeat these steps for the penny. Creating the player will be slightly different. Assign this.player array to the create from object function and provide the necessary data. The player is an animated sprite created from PNG images. Pass in the key of the first image in the sprite animation sequence. Then assign this.player to the zero index of this.player array. For the sprite animation, create player go with the value of this.amins.create. Pass an object specifying the animation key, frames as an array with the image texture key and optional duration in milliseconds, frame rate, and repeat property set to -1. Play the animations using the animation key. Let's get our player moving with the physics and cursor controls. Give the player physics using this.physics.add.existing, pass in the player in boolean false. Passing in false allows us to assign a dynamic physics body. Set the player's physics body to collide with the world and disable gravity interference. Create this.cursors to store the result of this.input.keyboard.createCursorKeys, which provides an object with hotkeys for up, down, left, right, spacebar, and shift. In update, set the player body x and y velocity to 0. Use conditions to check if up or down is pressed and move the player body in the corresponding direction. Repeat for left and right. This setup enables simultaneous movement in both x and y directions if necessary. We're going to finalize player controls by adding world boundaries and configuring the camera to view the entire world. Set the bounds for physics.world and camera.main by providing the x and y of the top left corner along with the width and height bounds. Tell the camera to follow the player. Complete the tile map with physics and collision detection. Add a collider between the player and obstacle layer. We need to specify which tiles are going to have the collider. Identify these tiles in the obstacle layer data in the JSON map. Find the highest and lowest number for that range to have a collision with the player. To apply physics to our coin, consolidate pennies and quarters into a single array. Then create a group called this.coins, turn on the world bounds, and allow gravity off. Iterate through the coins array and add each coin to the physics group. Enable collision detection by using this.physics.add.overlap with the player in the coins group. Include a callback function to execute when the overlap occurs, null in the callback context. Our callback function is called collect. It takes in the player and the overlapped item. The function removes and hides the overlap item from the group and disables its physics body. Great job. Please like and subscribe. To learn about sprite animations and designing tile maps, check out the link videos.